One must be very smart, intelligent, and hardworking who can invent, design, analyze, build and test machines, difficult systems, structures, gadgets and material to fulfill functional objectives and requirements, while considering the limitations imposed by practicality, regulation, safety and cost. Hello guys, I'm Sheetal and welcome back to Target Study YouTube channel. No, I'm not leaving that conversation about that one smart person here. Let's talk about it little longer. So who is that one professional who is smart enough to do all those things I have mentioned little earlier? Any guess? Of course, that professional is an engineer. We all know that to become anything, we need proper knowledge about it. And how can you get that proper knowledge? Yes, by doing a proper course. And thanks to the advancement that we have courses for almost all the profession. So, now it's clear that today I have something in store for those who are interested in technical line and want to make their career in the field of engineering and technology. If you are one of them, then this video will be helpful to you. After watching this video, you will surely get the detailed information about every single aspect of B.Tech, like what exactly B.Tech course is, what are the eligibility conditions to get admission in B.Tech, which are the entrance exams that are required to get admission in B.Tech, which are the top colleges to get your B.Tech done, which are the various specializations or trade of B.Tech course, what are the job opportunities and career prospects after completing B.Tech, and much more. So let's get started. Before going into the details, let me first tell you what exactly B.Tech course is. B.Tech, also known as Bachelor of Technology, is an undergraduate level engineering and technology program that is pursued by science stream students after the completion of class 12th, usually with physics, chemistry, and mathematics as their main subjects at this level. The four-year program is offered by hundreds of top engineering colleges across India, including world-renowned Indian Institute of Technologies, National Institute of Technologies, and Indian Institute of Information Technologies in regular mode. Now, after knowing about the course meaning, you must know the eligibility conditions for B.Tech. B.Tech is an UG-level professional engineering program. Therefore, the eligibility required to seek admission to B.Tech program is Class 12 pass in Science Stream with Physics, Chemistry, and Mathematics as compulsory subjects at this level. Some reputed engineering institute may also demand a certain minimum percentage in 12th class that can be anywhere between 50 to 70%. 3 years polytechnic diploma in relevant trade is also accepted by some engineering colleges for providing admission to second year of B.Tech lateral entry program. Along with fulfilling the eligibility conditions, you must have some required skills. Like the first and foremost requirement to do this course is the presence of technical bent of mind, along with your critical and positive attitude towards all the problems. You must be resourceful because you need to rely on concepts and know when to refer books and engineering guides to solve a problem. Along with this, you should be good in implementing ideas, problem solving, cooperative, curious about your work, and above all, you should have the desire to continuous learning, as an engineering project may take months or even years to materialize. Now, for doing B.Tech, it is important to know its admission process. There are lakhs of young boys and girls who aspire to get admission in the best engineering college every year. Roughly speaking, nearly 12 to 15 lakh candidates compete for nearly 50,000 seats in reputed engineering colleges, thereby making the process of engineering admission quite competitive. So the aspirants need to crack some really tough engineering entrance exams to grab a seat, which is the only way to the best engineering college. Now let me tell you about the main engineering entrance exams conducted by various bodies to provide admission in B.Tech courses of top engineering institutes. Don't worry, my dear friends, the list is quite curtailed now. And the first and most important engineering entrance exam is Joint Entrance Exam Main, which is used to provide admission to almost all the major engineering colleges across India except IITs. And the second in list is Joint Entrance Exam Advance, which is conducted to provide admission in IITs. Some other state and institute level engineering entrance exams that you can take are VITEE, that is Vellore Institute of Technology Engineering Entrance Exam, SRM Joint Entrance Exam, BITSAT, that is Birla Institute of Technology and Science Admission Test, COMED, that is Consortium of Medical Engineering and Dental Colleges of Karnataka, KIITEE, that is Kalinga Institute of Industrial Technology, Bhubaneswar, WBJEE, that is West Bengal Joint Entrance Examination, and Maharashtra Common Entrance Test, etc. Now let me tell you about the specializations of B.Tech. Earlier, few common specialization or trades were available for engineering candidates, including civil, mechanical, electrical, and electronics and communication. But advancement of technology in the last couple of decades has increased this list by including some 200 new trades. Some of the highly in-demand trades that you can think of taking can be computer science, information technology, electronics and communication, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, aerospace engineering, civil engineering, and chemical engineering, etc. Guys, this list is too long and every trade has its own value. So you can take any trade depending upon your area of interest and liking. For complete list of trade in engineering, you can visit our site targetstudy.com. Now let us move to another important question, that is which are the top engineering and technology courses offering B.Tech degree? There are nearly 5,000 engineering colleges across India providing BE or B.Tech courses in about 200 engineering trades that you can join to complete your B.Tech course. However, if you want to join some of the best government engineering and technology institutes, then you can join any of the 23 Indian Institutes of Technologies, 31 National Institute of Technologies, and almost same number of Indian Institute of Information Technologies, besides top state level engineering colleges like Punjab Engineering College, Chandigarh, Delhi Technological University, New Delhi, Aligarh Muslim University, Aligarh, University College of Engineering, Hyderabad, and Madras Institute of Technology, Chennai, etc. And if you wish to go for private engineering college, then you can go for Thapar Engineering College, Patiala, Chandigarh University, Mohali, Vellore Institute of Technology, Vellore, Lovely Professional University, Jalandhar, Amity University, Noida, Kalinga Institute of Industrial Technology, Bhubaneswar, PSG College of Technology, Coimbatore, KLE Technological University, Hubli, Karnataka, Birla Institute of Technology, Pilani, and SRM University, to name a few. When we think of joining any course, one question that always pop up in our minds is about the fee of that course. So guys, the fees for any B.Tech course varies from institute to institute depending upon its gender and reputation. However, on an average, a government engineering institute like Punjab Engineering College may demand anything between ₹50,000 to ₹60,000 per semester, whereas the average fee for the same course in a reputed private engineering college may vary between ₹1 lakh to ₹1.5 lakh per semester. As there is great variation in the fee structure of different engineering institutes, therefore it is always advisable to go through the latest brochure of the institute to get the exact figures before joining any institute. Now I would like to tell you about the career prospects and job opportunities after doing B.Tech course. Guys, I would like to tell you that there are ample of career prospects and job opportunities after B.Tech. In fact, I think there will hardly be any organization or sector where there will be not any need of B.Tech degree holders. Depending upon the trade one has taken in B.Tech degree, you can get employment in public sector enterprises like BHEL, BSNL, NFL, Shipping Corporation of India, Power Grid, IOCL, etc. Common boards and departments like Railways, Electricity Board of State Government, Public Works Department and other infrastructure development organization, private multinational companies like Google, Facebook, Twitter, Microsoft, TCS, Wipro, Larsen and Turbo, and CNC Constructions, etc. If you want to go for academics or research, then you can do PhD in the related field and join some educational institute or research facility as a lecturer or researcher. Besides, you can also think of joining Defence Forces in their engineering course. Indian Engineering Services exam can be another option of joining government sector's administrative post. So guys, there are ample of opportunities after B.Tech degree. With just one rider that you have done this degree from a well-reputed recognized institute like IITs or the best state-level engineering institutes. Now, one of the most important question, that is, what is the average salary of a B.Tech degree holder? Engineering is one such area where there is huge variation in the pay package which greatly depend upon three things. Number one, the reputation of the institute from where you have done your B.Tech. Number two, the trade you have taken in your B.Tech course. And number three, the sector you have joined. You will be surprised to know that the variation in pay scale is from Rs. 6 lakh per year to whooping 80 lakh to 1 crore per year. That's all from this video, guys. I hope you find this video informative. For more such videos, subscribe Target Study YouTube channel, and to get regular notification, hit the bell icon. Thank you for watching.